But is it gonna fit on my head though?
Okay.
Oh, this not. Ooh, yes.
There you go, styling. They trying to say I fell off because I ain't dropping a minute. Dropping a minute. This year I got so much heat for you rappers. I'm far unique. For the people who don't know, how did you think of Serene?
So first, I started off with like another girl as like a partnership. We didn't really have like a contract or anything, so she had come to me about like a clothing line idea or whatever. She just wanted some help, you know, getting on her feet and stuff like that. So I had ideas that I came to the table with. It was just like she wasn't really putting her like the same amount of work in I was. It was more like I was working harder and bringing more ideas, and she was just like stagnant. Like, kind of took it upon myself to, you know, use my ideas that I was bringing to the table and some other ideas that I had come up with, and started my own brand, because I just felt like, why am I working so hard, you know, for somebody, and they're not even, this is their dream, and they're not even like doing what they need to
do. So this was before it was Serene.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right, that makes sense.
And so when I started Serene, the name kind of came about from like my nickname, because my name backwards is Rima, so Reem came from that. And so like my friend was just talking about like having a name that's like so you, or like, you know, just representing yourself because you are your brand. So that's where I kind of got it.
How important is it that you got this female campaign that you got going on?
Because to me, when I was starting out, I didn't really have like a female mentor to look up to. I didn't really feel like a lot of females, you know, my age or like doing what I'm doing, really had that. So I kind of, you know, started the female campaign, you know, to show, you know, the girl bosses all around the world, and, you know, also, you know, being able to empower and inspire them, you know, to go out and get it, you know, how they can. So
have you gotten feedback like about the campaign from people and what they say?
You know, they loved it. They feel like really inspired about it. So, and plus it's like, I guess you could say, like, more spotlight for the brands that I'm featuring as well. So I had like clothing brands that I just featured, and, you know, just stuff like that. So it's more of like spotlight for both of us. So that's what I wanted to do.
So how does it feel just knowing that you're out here inspiring people, you know, to be themselves, love themselves, to, you know, be their own brand in a sense? I know that's my thing, but
yeah. Honestly, it feels good. I mean, that's the goal for me, to inspire, you know, other people, not only females but males as well. Yeah, it feels good. I mean, I never would have thought I would be, you know, the type of person to like inspire like others. But it's dope, you know, hearing like feedback from people. You know,
if you had to give one piece of advice on how to be your brand, what would it be?
I just say stand out and be original, be you. Don't try to like be like anybody else, because there's only one you. That's what I would say. Be you. Be original. Stand up.
What advice do you have, you know, to the other people who want to be entrepreneur but feel like they can't because of school?
It's not impossible. Learn how to balance. Time management is key. I'm still working on that because my time management is out the window. Because a lot of times you will, you know, be doing okay in school, and then you'll like get all these opportunities for your business, and then you'll choose your business over school, and then you'll see the result of that. I know. Just make sure you always keep school first. Finish like any assignment or studying, you know, a little bit earlier, so you can have enough time to plan whatever you need to plan for your business. Still be able to put yourself out there on campus, because that's really good. You have people from all over the world, you know, coming to school, and then they'll see your stuff, you know, buy it, all this other stuff. So just make sure you manage your time wisely. You'll be a full-time student, you'll have a part-time job, maybe two jobs, maybe three. I had three jobs. Yeah. So, yeah, you'll stress yourself out, you'll get overwhelmed, but that is okay. That's why you gotta pray, all this other jazz. A lot of people probably gonna say, oh, it's impossible to be a full-time student and an entrepreneur. It's BS. Just do whatever you wanna do. You know what I'm saying? It's your life, live it, so.
Have any final words, you know, any last minute plugs, any announcements you wanna make?
I will be in New York September 10th for Serene's New York Fashion Week show. I meet models, y'all, in October. Live models. I'm having something. I'm planning something. I can't really tell you what it is. I need live models. Send your information to SereneInquiries@gmail.com. I need your headshots. They don't have to be professional. I need your runway walks recorded. You could just be walking in the house with some heels on or some shoes. I'm looking for male and female. Oh, sizing. I need your sizes. That's very important. But I'm having a show in New York. Something else in October.
All right.
Welcome to my life. Okay, so I have a 35% off sale going on. I said that it ends tomorrow, but guess what? I'm extending the sale, y'all. Oh. Yeah, and I'm having a $5 off sale for Serene too. Everything's $5 off. Remember that. Hey everybody, my name is Amir Butler, and I was on episode 3 of BYOB. So check it out. Be watching for snakes on my blinds. I think I'm losing my mind. I don't know who in my squad. 'Cause niggas put on a disguise. Ain't really-